the 18th March of this year, the President of Uganda, Yoweri Museveni, announced a lockdown to prevent the country from having COVID-19. Different sectors and, of course, industries were put on a close until there is some kind of normal situation. Agriculture sector was never put under a lockdown, but of course, the impacts brought in by COVID-19 are still affecting those ones who are involved in it. Farmers are crying for low prices of agricultural products and they are calling for assistance from government. Urban Magazine this week, take a look into this matter.
Ugandan farmers are being brought to their knees by the lockdown that was aimed at stopping the spread of coronavirus. Borders were closed, restaurants and a lot of seasonal workers were sent home, meaning businesses in some sectors like tomato farming and banana farming are struggling due to lack of adequate storage and drying facilities as they wait for buyers. Currently, there is limited movement of traders or buyers of most agriculture-related produce due to the lockdown that was announced by the president as a means of preventing the spread of COVID-19. Frank Mutsha, a tomato farmer from the Family Life Farm in Kalukungu village in Sembabule district, is one of the tomato growers counting gross losses in this period. Mutsha, who ventured into tomato growing in 2018, says he has managed to overcome different challenges, but this time round, the COVID-19 pandemic has hit the agriculture sector so badly, attributing it to the lockdown, which prohibited the movement of the would-be clientele.
Abazigibazitwala tibaliyo Kampala abantu kati batono mbalala abantu batono kwa abantu bali mukuva muki mu bibuga ne badda mu byalo kata abasigaddemu jukira kata abasigaddemu endya yabwe abasinga bali awabwe tuli abantu bali angu restaurant kakati restaurant ezo tizikyakola bulungi kakati atenga restaurant ezo na ma hotel kasi kutwali nyanya zo.
When you reach at Mujisha's farm, what you see at first sight are rotten tomatoes on the ground, which signifies the lack of market for the harvest.
Dola wakati, nyanya twakanoga mu mirundi giri ebiri. Nenga munoga mirundi ebiri. Enyanya zinonga bwada byo waguru bagenda bazikasuka. Bazo nonira ddala ne bakubanga bajjanga bazagala. Akugamba nti njagala mu category eno ebweti, njagala mu nene, njagala mu nene ntono. Katate ebyo kubabikola baba gwe atu umulimi babanga abakusaze enyanya kubanga enyanya bo ebisere bisinga bo tubaye tuzirimira uli ngabajja bateka mu tesi enyanya napakira nti nyagala fry 10 napakira upakisi fry 10 nagenda.
Mutsha adds that in an investment of 12 million that he injected in these 3 acres of tomatoes, he has so far managed to reap not more than a quarter of the total capital injected in the farm.
We want one rubber one. Gatwe misa tractor sobra kumalao. Bafuna tractor. Nayenga tractor emo kugireta. Bona situjina kumpi. Tractor yakugireta one kutwali mitwala 3.5. Ontwali misa emirundi ebiri je mitwala 7. Kati bogagwa okuteeka mu ensigo yokka eyawano. Oteeka okuteeka mu ensigo kumpi milioni nga 2. Kate abalima nga omaze okuteeka mu tractor balimirawo milioni 3 n'ekitundu. Kate bw'omala obusa bukawano bwakwata milioni 2. Bw'okwata ebigimusa obukadde kumpi nga busa. Bwene weengerageranya twataddewo obukadde 10-12.
Mujisha, who grows the Asila type of tomatoes, says that from this season he had anticipated good harvest, but due to the crisis of the lack of market caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, A box of tomatoes, which was estimated to be costing 200,000 shillings, now costs just between 20,000 and 60,000 at the farm. But how much did he expect to earn from his 3 acres of tomatoes this season?
Season no enonga bokiraba wano twetufuna wo milioni ngabiri mutano iyo na biri mutano ne milioni asa twandi badosoro kuzifuna singe nyanya kankwejo kati wano badi wano applying ebi wano ola applying ebi 12 zibade za bala bulungi twazimina mu budde twazi weddagala twazi wa ebijimuse ebimala twandi badifuna milioni ngasa ne katuli mukulwana okufuna milioni nya ta nabakozi bokka abakola mu okulima tusobola kuwasasula. Kati government kyeyinza okuyamba mu fainga abalimi kwe kulaba nti ebyo ebikozesebwa mu kufukirira tubifuna ku sente entono kuba kati tuyina association Farm Life One singa basobola okugamba nti tugenda kuwanga loan osobola okufuna ebintu ebyo ebigikwata amazzi togenda kukozesa wano wokka nebaliraanwa bali obawa ku sente entonotono ate ebintu ebyo bisobola okubanga obifunye ku sente ensaamusaamu era kikuyambako okubanga ennyanyo zikuumye nga zirina amazzi zikuyambyeko okubanga nti nebaliraanwa obo baddeko kuba nebaliraanwa gye bakoma okulima gye musobola okufuna akatale akaamaanyi ate akalungi.
Mudsha offers some advice to fellow farmers, specifically to those who are dealing in tomato growing.
Kizibu chetu inanti zine nyanya, tuetago kufuna engeri jetu zikuma katezono onese. Ituva kuchindo cho gamante nyanya za afude, akatale kabuza zivini mtu wadu munana, katibaka zade mtu wadu mukaga, katinze mfiridwa. Kizibu chetu wagada okuchu usamu.
Mudsha has advised farmers to form or join groups to enjoy the bigger markets and advantages that come up with being together.
Singa tukwate nyanya zino ngabo ziraba ne tusobola kuzija ko kine chikuta kyazo sigaza mu nyama yomunda no giteka mu kakebeka ayo no gisiringa enyanya ezo sobola kuzitunda no mwako ogujanga weziri oba katale we kali obate kaliwo kwete kibate chikukosa omulimi nebyo byetaaga okubanga abantu bafe tubatadde wamu ne tuwabulira ekirungi ekiri mu kintu kino n'okufuna obusobozi obukola ekintu kino kijja kuyambako loosi eno gye mulabawo.
Whereas we are seeing these cries from different farmers, the government made sure that the agriculture sector receives more funding in the 2020-2021 national budget. Now we are taking a short break. When we return, we want to find out different other measures that can be used to make sure that the agriculture sector is getting boosted.